Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we are going to review Deadless VR, a game that was recently re-released on March 23rd, 2021 on the Oculus Store App Lab. So this game is not available on the normal Oculus Store. However, you can download it through App Lab for the Oculus Quest and the Oculus Quest 2. It was released by developer Vertical Robot. It normally retails for $5. I had previously purchased this game on the Oculus Go platform, but I decided to buy it again for the Oculus Quest 2. It's also been available for the Samsung Gear VR and the Google Daydream. Deadless VR is a puzzle platformer slash exploration artsy game, and basically you have limited flight and you have to figure out how to get on the triangles, and as you progress through the levels, different mechanics are introduced to make that a little bit more difficult. However, this is purely a casual puzzle platformer. This is not a difficult game at all. It's actually pretty easy, pretty casual. It's meant more as a chill artistic experience, and it's just one of those games where you can sort of enjoy flight in VR that's not too intense. So if you normally get motion sickness, this might be a game that'll start you off on the path to try more intense experiences in VR. Deadless VR has 20 total levels, including the tutorial levels, and it took me about an hour and a half to complete the game. Deadless VR is running on the Unreal Engine, and even though it's a pretty old game, it actually looks really good on the Oculus Quest 2. I would say it's one of the better looking games on the Oculus Quest standalone platform. You do have snap turning and smooth turning available in this game, as well as comfort option blinders that you can turn on or turn off in the settings. The game ran smoothly for me, and I did not experience any issues or bugs. Overall, I would say that I enjoyed my time in this game. It's a lovely, chill game, and it's budget price, so I think the content does match the price point for this game. And I think this game is perfect to introduce someone to VR, especially someone who is just a casual gamer. However, if you're looking for a challenging puzzle platformer, then this is not the game for you, and you probably will not enjoy this game. It's not challenging at all. And really, the joy from this game is just a traversal from point A to point B. There's like a nice feeling of flight and learning the game mechanic, and there are new mechanics introduced with the new chapters. However, it never really comes together in a challenging way. And like I mentioned before, locomotion is through this limited flight mechanic where you're basically jumping and then you're gliding to get to the next platform section. You'll have to find some switches that you jump into. You'll also use these little wind gusts that'll help you glide through the air through longer distances, and also use trampolines that'll make you jump even higher. It's basically a two button mechanic game. Use the triggers to jump and to glide, and then you'll use any other button to brake. And for me personally, Deadless VR is more of an artistic game, more of an exploration game than it is a puzzle platformer. And that's because the puzzle platforming sections are just a little too easy. But it is fun to traverse these worlds, and it is a beautiful world to explore, and it does have nice music. At this budget price, I can definitely recommend this game, and if I have to rate it, I would give it a 6.5 out of 10. Definitely, I think this is a game that's a classic, and if you haven't experienced it before, I would recommend it. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. If you liked my review, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day and enjoy the rest of the video.